welcome to another Bolo Lore video. This one's going to be a shorty because it's a companion video to my Bolo AI Lore video. This time we'll be touching on and exploring Operator Identification Syndrome, or OIS for short, because, well, Operator Identification Syndrome is just too much of a mouthful to say a bunch of times in this video. So let us begin by defining OIS, because while the lore uses it as a plot device, it poorly defines it. In lore, Bolo commanders are accused of succumbing to OIS when they cease treating their commands as equipment and begin treating them as human or, in extraordinarily rare cases, fall in love with them. To the latter point, only two cases are known in lore, Captain Paul Merritt with Nike and Captain Menenka Trevor with Benji. Fortunately, Concordiat designers never saw Star Trek or presumably Japanese hentai and never made a Bolo atomically correct and fully functional. Thank God for that. Now, Rule 34 and all joking aside, when we discuss OIS, we are only referring to the condition between Bolos and their military commanders, not civilians. A civilian will have not gone through the rigorous screening, training, mental assessments, or be expected to maintain the mental discipline required to command military units. Because despite what popular media tells you, not any idiot can command a military force, even in the apocalypse. In theory, you need someone who has quick thinking, cool under pressure, and that understands that he may be required to sacrifice their charges on the altar of war. Again, theoretically easy on paper, it's a lot harder when you know your charges personally. Could you willingly send your own kid to their deaths, even not knowing the overarching goal? It's a lot of uncertainty and extraordinarily stressful. That's why military leaders are carefully cultivated and trained. Soldiers and equipment are expensive. If you have a soft leader, for example, like General G.S. McClellan for the Union Army, fear of casualties can paralyze you. But conversely, a callous commander like Major General G. Pickett can cost you a whole army. A civilian who's never served will never understand or generally even comprehend that level of stress, so they can't be expected for them to behave accordingly and tend to over-identify with Bolos, especially when they sound a little too human. Bolo commanders, however, are in charge of literal mountains of vastly expensive equipment and generational knowledge. To trust them with this, the Concordiat must be assured that a commander won't buckle while directing world-ending levels of firepower. Realistically, OIS didn't begin to truly manifest in the brigade until CY-2736, with the introduction of the Mark 20, the first true psychotronic AI. Though Marks 20 through 24 were generally blunted, direct, and even bloodthirsty personality-wise, it was still a concern over time many units of the line developed human analog personalities while not deviating in a way to trigger the Omega Worm kill switch. It manifested more frequently as marks increased notably beyond the Mark 23 to 25. Efforts were made to stem this, including shackling or blunting the personality core outside of battle reflex mode, limiting the operator's exposure to AI personality to blunt peer bonding, as well as giving computerized vocoder voices instead of the gendered human voices found on later marks. Conversely, anyone who's served knows that soldiers and sailors always form a bond with their equipment. From the marine and the rifle to a captain and their ship, it's inevitable, it's human nature. The concern occurs when either a commander or charge is willing to disobey orders to save the life of the other. Granted, like I stated earlier, the Omega Worm prevents this in Bolos, but no analog exists in the human commander. Concern evaporated, though, with the fielding of the Mark 32 onward, introduction of the neural interface. Any pretense of preventing OIS disappeared with this innovation because it allowed commanders to directly interface with the Bolo. This resulted in something entirely unexpected and wonderful. It produced the perfect killing machine. It fused Bolo speed and power with human rage and intuition. An extremely terrifying prospect, but it was developed on the eve of the final war anyway. And necessity is the mother of invention, I guess. But that's just this geek's opinion. It's a tough to discuss what should be a clinical subject and not delve into the philosophy of the attachment of man and machine, and hopefully I haven't tossed anyone down too far of a rabbit hole. I'd love to hear your opinions on OIS. Is it avoidable? Worth considering tactically? Is it something we can just discount because it's going to happen anyway? Let me know in the comments down below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and we'll see you on the next battlefield. Peace.